In Bruges, or Bruges, or Bros, whatever, is a dark comedy action movie about two hitmen sent to a small Belgium town after a particularly messy contract. Colin Farrell and Brendan Gleeson play the lead roles. Farrell's character is a hotshot pretty boy who's bored out of his mind, while Gleeson plays an older, wiser character who is in love with the history and culture of the town. So, let's get started. Now, a lot of the humor arises from the juxtaposition between the two interesting characters that are Gleeson and Farrell, as they have an incredible chemistry on the screen as they portray their characters in a realistic way. Ralph Fiennes also comes through with another great villain performance. Director-writer Martin McDonagh won an Oscar for Best Original Screenplay on this, and rightfully so. I thoroughly enjoy the fact that the characters in this movie act like people, not Hollywood characters, and I really appreciate that. The first act is slower moving, but the second and third are filled with tension, and after a major plot point sets the film in motion, the plot moves along in waves, with multiple exciting climaxes. It avoids cliches as it progresses through the film, getting more strange. The movie has a certain soul to it, and it's unpredictably reminiscent of a Tarantino film. It seems to have its own style and originality. McDonagh is as good of a director as he is a writer, and after seeing his second feature film, an incredibly underappreciated Seven Psychopaths, I am beyond excited to see what he does next. It's well shot throughout and does a good job displaying the fairytale-esque small Belgian town. The film has decent symbolism and metaphors that aren't shoved down your throat, which is much appreciated. But what makes this film stand out is the genre blendiness. The movie is rare as it succeeds in both of its genres. I laughed out loud during all three acts of this film, and the movie never lost its heart throughout. The action in the film is suspenseful and unique in a way that it never goes over the top. The scenes feel incredibly real. The characters act in a manner that seems entirely realistic. The third act feels less like an action movie and more like classic literature, which is a compliment. The film gives many one-liners that result in a self-conflict in the viewer. The film questions your morals, beliefs, and basic fundamental ideas, without ever being too heavy or smashing you over the head with any particular theme or correct viewpoint. Which is fitting, because our two main protagonists are in fact murderers, and what it does best is it ends the story at just the right time, giving us all we need to complete the full arc of the story and the characters, and left me stunned and thinking in my head for a few minutes after. Overall, yes, go watch this movie. I give it an 8.5 out of 10.
I am talking to you. What's fucking unbelievable?
Well, I'll tell you what's fucking unbelievable, shall I? Blowing cigarette smoke straight into myself and my girlfriend's face. That's fucking unbelievable.
This is the smoking section.
I don't care if it's the smoking section. Right? She directed it right in my face, man. I don't want to die just because of your fucking arrogance.
Uh-huh. Isn't that what the Vietnamese used to say?
Vietnamese? What are you talking about, the Vietnamese? That statement makes no fucking sense at all.
Yes, it does. The Vietnamese!
Well, saying it over and over ain't gonna make any more sense out of it. How does the Vietnamese have any relevance whatsoever to myself and my girlfriend having to breathe your friend's cigarette smoke? Tell me how saying...
That's for John Lennon, you Yankee fucking cunt.